All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is Tyrone Docherty. He is the CEO of First Tellurium Corp. And Tyrone, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Oh, wonderful. Thanks, Steve. Pleasure to be back with you. Looking forward to talking about the company.
Yeah, lots of stuff going on with the company. We'll get to that in a second, but maybe just give everyone a little bit of background on First Tellurium. Maybe we'll start with Tellurium and so everyone understands what it is you're doing.
Well, tellurium is one of the more critical metals. It's one of the eighth or ninth rarest metal in the world, same scarcity as platinum. And it's used primarily in a couple of areas, cadmium tellurium solar panels. And obviously solar panels are getting bigger and bigger with the green movement, and also used in thermoelectrics. But more important to ourselves, especially for Canadian viewers, is that about a year or so ago, in January of 2022, University of British Columbia patented a lithium tellurium battery, which is far superior to a lithium ion battery. And we expect to get some movement there as well. So the tellurium answers the green aspect of it, but that certainly doesn't encompass what we're doing. In Canada, we've got a high grade gold and silver property, which is great economically. And the tellurium is mixed in with that. So we're not relying on only tellurium to make us go, because if you relied on only tellurium, you'd be stuck in a place. You need these other minerals to help you go.
Yeah, let's talk about the project. So tell me the name of it and where you are as far as its development is concerned, or at least its exploration.
Yeah, well, we have a property called the Deerhorn property. It's located not too far from Huckleberry, about 35 kilometers as a crow flies, I should say. And it's a high-grade gold-silver tellurium property. And we had a preliminary economic assessment done in 2018. And it said we had robust economics, and it was a 1.6-year payback, 42% IRR after tax. And Steve, the interesting thing, that was based on $1,300 gold and $17 silver. So obviously we're even more robust than that, and we expect to have an update hopefully here soon on what those numbers look like in 2023. But in addition to that, last October, our QP, Dr. Lee Grote from University of British Columbia, walked the property. And in addition to extending our known zone, which was 2.4 kilometers of the gold, silver, tellurium, he extended up to 3.5 kilometers. More importantly, or perhaps as importantly, they discovered a new copper porphyry system on the other side of the mountain, which every junior in the world is looking for copper porphyry. So we're actually blessed with all these minerals on our property. So to make sure we get ready for our drill program this year, we actually bought our own drill in February, and that came from a company in Alaska that had a brand new drill that sold it to us on one condition, Steve, and that was that we gave them shares of the company. They didn't want cash, because their driller walked the property and said, this looks phenomenal. So again, I can say how wonderful it is. Other people say, but when independent people say we want shares instead of cash, that sort of says what you want to hear.
Yeah, so tell me about the drill program this year. What are you guys looking at? Are you looking at the copper side, looking at the gold side, or both?
Well, the first thing we're going to do is fill in on the gold, silver, tellurium zone, which was subject to that PEA, as I mentioned, because we'd only done 20% of our known zone. So we're going to do some more fill-ins. And obviously, we'll look at some areas where they just extended it by walking in October, just to show how much big it is, because it's still open. And just for your viewers, we only drilled down an average of 60 meters. So 200 feet. So there's lots of room for extension down below. So most of the drilling will be put on the gold, silver, tellurium, about 1,000 to 1,100 meters, 1,200 meters. And then we're going to probably put 300 to 400 meters on the copper side, just to show the copper boys that, yes, in fact, we do have a porphyry there. And I'm sure that'll get the interest that we need to get generated.
Yeah, so that's going to happen in the summertime, basically?
Yeah, it'll be either August 1st or September 1st, depending on what the snow situation looks like. But before that, we're going to do an IP survey in May. And then Dr. Grote is sending up a number of his grad students to do a soil sampling program over the whole area. Because thanks to Mother Nature and global warming, we're up a mountain that's normally been covered by snow and ice. So that's starting to melt. So we're finding all kinds of interesting minerals that couldn't be found before. So it's a very exciting situation. And I know in this interview, we don't have a chance to talk about our wonderful property in Colorado, which is one of, if not the highest grade tellurium property in the world, which I'd love to discuss later on. So we're very blessed to be in the situation that we're in.
Absolutely. Well, it sounds like it's going to be pretty busy for sure. Tyrone, thanks so much for the update. Appreciate it. And I know we're going to talk again real soon.
Thank you, Steve. Much appreciated.
All right. Tyrone Docherty, the CEO of First Tellurium Corp.